Remember Islam with Abu Ahmad, just in case you forgot.
يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وابتغوا إليه الوسيلة وجاهدوا في سبيله لعلكم تفلحون.
الحمد لله, all praises due to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We praise Him, we seek His help and forgiveness. We seek refuge in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala from the evils of ourselves and from the wickedness of our own deeds. Today's topic is going to be very important. It is about a word called taqwa. The word taqwa has been mentioned in the Quran over than 250 times. 250 times. In English, we can understand the word taqwa to mean fear, piety, or to be conscious or aware of. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in a translated meaning as well, O you who believe, have taqwa, fear of Allah, and believe in His Messenger. He, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, will bestow upon you a double portion of His mercy. And He will provide for you a nur, a light, which you will walk with. Subhanallah. If you have this taqwa and you believe in the Messenger, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give you this great nur, this great light that you're going to walk with. And this light is going to open up your mind. A great companion, Abdullah ibn Abbas radiallahu anhumah, he reported, one day I was behind the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and he said to me, O young man, let me teach you some words of advice. He said, be mindful. In other words, remember, be aware, be conscious of Allah. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will protect you. He will protect you. Be conscious or mindful of Allah and you will find Him in front of you. If you have to ask, ask Allah. And if you have to seek help in whom? In Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. What a great lesson. What a great lesson. Imagine each and every single one of us lived upon this advice. How much would you prosper in the dunya? And imagine how much you'd prosper in the hereafter. Subhanallah. Ali radiallahu an, he had some great words. He said, taqwa is to fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to act upon the revelation, to be content with little, and to prepare for the day of travel. Allahu Akbar. Allahu Akbar. Act upon the revelation, meaning what? It means to learn the Quran. So many of us don't pick up the Quran and read. So many of us don't even understand the Quran. Ali went on and said, be content with little. Be content with little. This is one of the major problems. We are so greedy, my dear brothers in Islam. We want so much. How content are you? Most of us living in the Western countries are living a life of luxury. Wallahi we are. A ummah of Muhammad. We have become so spoiled. We want everything. Honestly, we want everything. And we are never content with what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given us. We have become a greedy ummah. So let us be honest with ourselves. What hardship are we going through? What hardships, O slaves of Allah, are you going through? Each and every one of us has a car, if not two. Some of us may have three. Each and every one of us, we go away on weekends. We have enough money to go away and take the family. And every year, maybe you go once or twice overseas on a trip. And we complain we don't have enough. We complain we don't have enough. We eat what we want, when we want, and we complain. And subhanAllah, you notice when you're invited or when you come home, imagine your wife just put you a little piece of bread and some soup in front of you. You would honestly look at her and frown and say, what is this? Woman, are you crazy? What have you put in front of me? Where's my dinner? We are not content. We just want and want and want. Now, I just want you all to imagine. You were living in a third world country. In a place where you didn't have all the glory and glamour that we have here. Imagine. You didn't have fresh water running into your house. Imagine. Let's go to the worst place where water could go is in the toilet. You would not even have the facilities to have a toilet in your house. Just imagine, you had to walk for 2 days, putting your poor little baby on your back, places like Africa, tied to your back. You had to walk for 2 days in the heat, just to find some water that is muddy. We would not even drink it, we wouldn't. Imagine having to walk. Imagine sitting there watching your own children crying, day after day. because you could not feed them. Imagine dying one by one in front of your eyes and we complain. We've mentioned many times how hungry the Prophet ﷺ was, and he had to tie a stone to his stomach because he was starving. A messenger of Allah who could have had whatever he wanted, he was starving. He went to battles. He went through hardships. He was thrown out of Mecca. His family turned him away. They wanted to kill him. And you, O slave of Allah, are going through what? What are you going through? Hardship? Show me the hardship. Show me the hardship. There is no hardship, wallahi. We're just selfish people. That's all it is. We are selfish. And my dear brothers, try to live on as little as you can. Try. Ali radiallahu anhu went on and he said, prepare yourself for the day of travel. Prepare yourself for the day of travel, which means get ready for that day when you're about to die. Prepare your luggage. So many of us don't remember Allah throughout the day. So many of us, and it's unfortunate, do not pray. Do not pray, subhanAllah. How are you going to face Allah on the day of judgment? If you don't pray, you come one day a week to Jummah. You may pray the whole month of Ramadan and that is it. Understand, on the day of judgment, the first thing that you're going to be accounted for is your salat. Your salat, your prayer. And if it's not good, every single thing you've done in your life is in vain. You're not going to get rewarded for it. But if you had prayed, then everything else would come. We look out, we watch the movies, we watch TV, we listen to music, and all we want to become is what? Pop stars. We want to become movie stars. We want to become sporting stars. How many of us know what happened to Tiger Woods? What do you know about Allah and His Messenger? How much? But you know about Tiger Woods and you don't know about your Messenger. You don't know about your Creator, but you know about Tiger Woods. Change the way that you think of your brothers in Islam. Walk outside, what do we see? We see haram. You look this way, you see haram. You look that way, you see haram. You turn on the TV, you see haram. Why? Everything is sold with sex. Everything. You always see a naked woman in front of you. So our minds are deluded. How are you going to fix your soul if you do not fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? If you don't have taqwa, how are you going to fix yourself up? And let us look at the ummah. MashaAllah, so many brothers and sisters praying, fasting, so many people coming back to the deen, so many brothers growing beards, so many sisters putting on the hijab. Yes, we look good from the outside, but in reality, look at how many diseases we have on the inside. Look at how many diseases, whether you go up to the top or to the bottom of the ummah of Islam. We look at the best of us that have so many faults. SubhanAllah. And our sins are crushing the success of the ummah. Yes, we all know it. But what are we doing about it? What are we doing to change this problem within our society? We all sit back and say, you know what? Let that brother do it. Let that brother do it. No one has time. No one has time. What are you doing to help this community? What are you people doing for Islam? When someone needs help, where are you? It's not enough just to say, I'm a Muslim. Or to say that I fear Allah. It's not enough. You have to understand Iman has three qualities. Number one, you believe in your heart. You believe it in your heart. You say it with your tongue. And you act it with your limbs. Three things. This is the way that you're a true Muslim, inshallah. Many of us wonder why we have so many issues with our families, with our health, with our wealth. Wallahi, every time you commit a sin, you're doing harm to yourself and your family. If you have a child that is sick, look back at yourself. If you have a business that's not successful, look back at yourself. Maybe it is because you do not fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah is testing you and He's trialing you so that you can come back. Maybe Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has said in the Quran, in a translated meaning, whatever misfortune befalls you, it is because of what your hands have earned. It is clear. Whatever misfortune that befalls you, it is because of what your hands have earned. It is because of our own actions. This is the reason why so many Muslims are being tortured all over the world. So many Muslims getting killed all over the world. Think of yourself. So the solution to all our problems is for us to fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala the way that He should be feared. We need to return to the straight path. We need to wake up and understand the reality of life. My dear brothers in Islam, when was the last time that you cried for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? When was the last time a couple of teardrops dropped because of something that you read through the Quran? Or something that you heard about the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam or his companions, and this shook you and you felt goosebumps all over your body and tears started to roll down your face? When was the last time? And the authority of Ibn Abi Mulaika, who said, we were sitting with Abdullah ibn Amr on a rock. He said, and listen carefully, weep, weep. And if you cannot weep, then make yourself weep. If only you knew, listen, if only you knew, you would pray until your back broke. You would continuously pray until your back broke. And you would weep until your last voice. They understood the religion. They understood the dunya. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam gave a similar advice. He said, O people, weep. O people, weep. For if you cannot weep, then make yourself weep. Indeed, the people of the hellfire will weep. The people in hellfire, they'll cry. They will cry so much until what? Their tears are all gone. Finished. Allah, no more tears. So what happens next? They start to cry blood. Blood would come out of their eyes. Until their eyes seemed like they were had ulcers around them. Do you want to be one of these people who are going to cry in the hereafter and not in the dunya? SubhanAllah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala rewards us. When we're sitting by ourselves and we contemplate Allah's words and we start to cry, there is a great reward in this. But when are you going to actually get up in the last third of the night or just sit by yourself and remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? We don't have time, do we? Make yourself have time. Change your life. Make sure that you have time. Abu Darda radiallahu anhu, he said about taqwa, taqwa is to fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So much so that one begins to fear Him even from potential sins, even if they were as small as an atom. Even if something was so small, we say, Allah, doesn't matter. It's only something small. It's a white lie. It's this, it's that. Doesn't matter. Move on. Every single sin will be shown on the Day of Judgment, even if it's as small as an atom. Ibn Mas'ud radiallahu anhu said, fear Allah as it should be feared means to obey Him. To obey Him and not to disobey Him. And to thank Him subhanahu wa ta'ala and not to be ungrateful to Him. So the question is, how many of us really fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? And does it show in your actions that you fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? And once a person asked the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam for some advice. Some simple advice. And you notice the words of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam are very, very small, but effective. So after asking the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, advise me, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, I advise you to fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala because it is the head of everything. Are you a strong Muslim or a weak Muslim? Why not be the strong Muslim rather than the weak Muslim? It is all up to yourself. Change yourself. Change yourself. Even if you sin accidentally now and then. Ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to forgive you because He's a forgiving Lord. Ask Allah to forgive you and continue in righteousness. Let us take the steps to guidance. Let us repent from our sins. Let us return to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and beg. Wallahi beg. Some people misunderstand Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves a slave who continuously asks Him. The slave that begs Him, the one that cries and says, oh Allah, please forgive me, over and over and over and over again. He loves this. Don't be shy and say, you know what, Allah's not going to listen to me. Sometimes, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He prolongs to answer the dua of a person. Just to see, is he a true slave? How patient is he? Or maybe he holds on to stop some affliction that's going to hit you. He may stop a harm from coming to you. You want to build houses every single day, my dear brothers, and I mention it over and over again, pray your tawaf sunan. 2 before Fajr, 4 before Dhuhr, 2 after Dhuhr, 2 after Maghrib, 2 after Isha, and then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will build for you every single day one, a mansion in Jannah. A mansion in Jannah. If we add all those minutes, it may take you 20 minutes a day. You are building a house for yourself in Jannah. Every single day. Take your time out. Worship your Lord properly. Don't rush. Take it easy. You can't say long suwab, just say the Fatiha, just to make it short for yourselves. You want mansions, build it in the hereafter. So let the hereafter be our main goal, and let us concentrate on Jannah.